when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah.
Son, though he was, he learned obedience.
But it's really the Lord who journeys with us and does the saving and the life-giving actions within our lives.
Good evening. As it relates to our gospel tonight, at the end where Jesus makes reference to his impending suffering with the passion and his desire for us to come closer to him, our class would like to put our human earthly suffering in perspective with what Jesus and Mary went through for us and for our salvation. To do this, we are portraying a couple different situations of suffering that people today may go through.
I just found out my girlfriend cheated on me. I feel betrayed because I trusted her like Jesus probably felt because he trusted Judas and was betrayed by him.
I've been homeless for a year and I feel so abandoned, just like Jesus probably felt when Peter denied him 3 times.
I just lost my older brother in a car accident, and I don't know how life will go on without him. Like Mary probably felt as she lost Jesus, her son, on the cross.
We all experience suffering, but nothing compares to the suffering of Jesus and Mary, who accepted it as God's will so all our sins could be forgiven. We should try to accept our suffering as a reminder of Jesus, of what Jesus suffered for us.
Jesus might have said, "Let me help you through your suffering and difficulties. The challenges you face are far too great for you to handle alone. You are aware of your helplessness. This awareness opens up a choice, to go it alone or to walk with me in dependence. Actually, this choice is always before you, but difficulties highlight the process. So, embrace these troubles as a reminder to come closer and rely on me."